Hello, this is Equin Clock.
And Ripper 95.
And we'd like to welcome you to yet another game that I used to play a lot during my childhood.
Yes. And you're probably thinking, I know what game this is going to be. And no, no you actually don't. So shut up and stop assuming things.
No, we are going to play Lego Bionicle the game.
How many people do you think out there are like, what the fuck?
35, at the most. Because that's how many subscribers I have. And no one else really cares. So, we decided to play this game because this is like a great game.
Oh god, the swimming levels.
It was very relevant in my childhood because, like, I didn't really play with Legos that weren't Bionicles.
Yeah. And if you did, get off our channel.
Yeah.
So Bionicles are clearly the most superior Legos.
So, not only are we going to talk about, like, some of the trivia of Bionicle and how, like, Lego chose Bionicle and all that crap, but we're also going to talk about the game as soon as the demo's over. I don't know how long the demo goes, but you know, I'll skip it, never mind. Yes, I want to create a new save.
Yeah, so we had to delete our previous save.
So that we didn't, like, start off at the beginning.
Yeah. So we could. Save successful, yay. Now, as you see, yes, the ending of this game will coincide with the ending of the first film. And we're going to shut up for the cutscene.
Is it really a cutscene?
I think it's a cutscene. Yeah, because I think this is them crashing into Earth. Or whatever island.
Matsunui.
Well, whatever planet they live on.
Oh. No, this is the chapter selection.
Oh.
Okay.
Now, this always pissed me off because they have these guys in Toa Nuva form. And then this guy's in Toa Mata, and that guy's in Toa Mata as well. Now, I think there are secrets. Yeah, there are extras.
What's in the extras folder up there?
What's in the Matsui Biscuit Guide?
Okay, we'll check that out.
Islanders, information, bosses, Rocky.
It's like a bestiality.
Okay. Now, it's a bestiality.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I know.
Go back to extras really quick. I want to see what the bonus content is, because I think you unlocked
it. What did I say?
It's like a bestiality.
No, what the fuck is wrong? Okay, so...
Okay, you see that? Hang on, let me turn on the volume. It's so loud. We've already gotten this to sync.
So, you have to unlock them different ways, like, through collecting light stones. We'll explain that in a bit.
Yeah. You'll see what they are in a minute. So, without further ado, let's actually start the damn game. And, unfortunately for EC... Oh.
And the great being sent us the Toa. To defeat Makuta and banish darkness from Matanui, raising him from slumber. Only the mighty Toa are able to remove the taint of Makuta from Naragi.
It's the Toa.
Yeah! Nicely done.
At least they got the voice actors from the movie to do the work.
Something is chasing me. You have to stop it. What's that noise?
Shut up, Takua.
I don't think it's friendly. I always thought Gali had the raddest mask. Like, she had, like, a really rad, like, 80s sunglasses. That was just, like, that kind of, like, one band of, like, metallic.
Makuta lives?
Flame smash.
You will not harm the Matori while the power of Matanui still flows through my veins.
Shield chip.
Oh.
Come at me, son. I'll save you.
We are in great danger. Let us travel back to our Wahi and deal with Makuta's dark threat.
I'm also apparently the only girl on this island.
I'm dizzy. Oh, that's gonna lag.
Okay, so like I was saying, unfortunately for EC here, we will be alternating the controller every time one of us dies.
Okay. Good thing I never died this game.
The bosses are the only place where I think we'll be alternating a lot.
Alright, so just a little of an FYI. The characters you're going to be playing are the Toa, which are kind of like...
If you've never played Bionicle, they're like the main superheroes of the group.
Yeah.
Of the island.
They're kind of like the full-grown, like, adult-sized ones.
That rock, I think, is glitching out.
So, right now we'll be playing the Toa of Fire, Toa Tahu.
Yeah, each one represents an element. They use fire, water, air, earth, ground, and ice.
Toa Tahu. Toa Toran had led
from the forum. Do not worry, Toa.
They're saying it.
I will see to their safety.
Yeah, and each one of, like, they said the Tahu Matoran. Each Matoran has, like, a different title for them, like, depending on where they live. The Tahu Matoran are from the fire area. I think the Koh Matoran are from the ice area.
Yeah, because each of them, like, adopt, like, the first two characters of the Toa's name in the naming of the town.
Yeah.
The controls, X's jump, squares, shield in this character, circle is like this attack, you got a double jump, you save this Matoran, which is like what the villagers, they're kind of childlike.
Yeah.
The red Matoran with the blue mask that we saw towards the beginning, that was,
shield yourself with square. They should convert dark energy attacks into elemental energy. See, I never really got the hang of that. So I just kind of hack and slash my way through this.
You could recharge your energy guide by catching dark energy in your shield or holding down.
See, I never really did that. I was just really bad at this game.
So
the only problem is if you hold that, you turn around really quick, make sure you didn't get any light stones back there. The only problem is while you're doing that, it doesn't act as a shield, and you're just drawing in energy, so that leaves you wide open for enemy attacks.
Which is kind of bad.
Wait, did that thing just take a light stone from us?
I don't know.
I think it did. I think it just hit a light stone under there. How the hell?
So
how is it possible to get all the light stones in this level?
I don't know. So the main enemies are known as the Rahi, and they are basically
the native inhabitants of this land, and you're coming in and killing them.
No, they're like animals, and they're only evil because the bad guy kind of possessed them and turned them evil. And
that's just what we said when we took over America.
The bad guy was possessing him?
Yes, the bad guy. Big Satan.
Oh, okay.
Oh, we got a new mask.
Was that a mask or was that a life?
I think that was a life, but it was they play it off as you're collecting masks.
Oh, okay.
That kind of pisses me off, though, that we can't get that light stone back.
Let me just second this. We just saved a second Matoran. I don't know if that was a light stone. We'll find out at the end. So then there's the villager. Which are the Matoran.
Yeah,
they're kind of short and stout, and they really can't do shit.
Yeah, until the selected few of them become Toa.
Which are basically like the warriors who protect the village, have the powers of the elements, all that fun.
I wouldn't really call it fun, since they'll have to die. Or like, well, if... There we go. I don't think I ever got that one. Like, I got, like, none of the secrets in this game when I played through.
Yeah. Well, it's been a long time since I played this one. I'm surprised I remembered all this. Of course, it's probably just the type of game that just stuck with me for such a long time.
Wow, okay. You can just lay that guy out.
That's how I played this game. Reminds me of how I played Battlefield a little bit, too.
Really, really carefully?
No, just lay them out.
Oh my god, you can get 36 on a level if you do like no left. For those of you who don't know, 36 is kind of a significant number in this, because there's 6 Toa, each one with a different mask, and in the original storyline, they had to find all 6 masks that belong to each other, since apparently there are extras of them lying around the island. And so 36 is the exact number of masters total that there were. Oh yeah, that's extra life, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Either that or it's like a health recharge, because we haven't taken a single hit yet.
Yeah. Well, no, we've taken a few hits, actually. You just managed to kill yourself.
Okay, recharge some energy so I can do more attacks. I don't know, I can't just like swing my sword at them. That'd be probably better for me.
Seeing as though it's on fire.
Yeah.
Your sword is literally on fire.
Well, it's because I'm a Toa of Fire.
The Toa of Fire?
Yeah, that's what I said.
We need Rahi's power to open this door. But all our friendly Rahi have fled from the Bulla. Let's give Matoran and help us to build a replacement.
Shut up, you.
Shut up, you're hurt.
Yeah. Technically, that character is not a Tomatorn, but he's instead disguised as a Tomatorn. He's really a Vomitorn, a Torn of Light. Which will become increasingly important later on in the story.
That would explain why his mask was a blue color, even though all of the Tomatorns have masks of red colors.
No, that's not anything to do with it. It's just the way the mask was colored.
Just Lego ran out of red pieces, so they gave him a blue piece instead.
Yeah, something like that.
That would turn around. You're missing a lot of stuff.
I know. I'm gonna come back around so I can grab these three. Actually, what is that? Is that a safe spade? I think that might be a checkpoint. Hold on, let me check. Point. Yeah. Oh no, it's a full recharge, I think.
Let's see.
Yeah, yep. Full recharge. Okay. So yeah,
scare around the island. Oh yeah, you don't take fall damage either, because you're made out of freaking metal and Legos.
Yeah.
Metal and Legos.
Metal Legos.
I swear to God, if we end up getting 99 freaking white stones, because that one thing like toppled a pillar on top of that light stone, I'm gonna be pissed.
Yeah. Alright. If you were to ask me about like 10 years ago what all these different Rahi were called, I probably would be able to tell you. It's just been that long.
If you guys really want, I can bring in my actual Rahi bestiary tomorrow.
I think I have my Rahi bestiary from the second generation.
Oh, I have mine first generation, but mine actually tells you the build. I'm like, wow, we're nerds.
Jesus, we're nerds.
Uh-huh. You took two hits earlier, so I wouldn't be too ashamed of it. Yeah, this is gonna be really awkward when you can't actually see what is lava and what's not, really, because we're still playing in black and white.
Yeah.
Oh, this motherfucker. I remember this guy from the story. Yeah, and if you noticed, his claws are in fact Matoran masks. Lego ran out of pieces.
No, that actually significant. It's, they actually crafted their own claws out of the Matoran they killed.
Oh, wow. Those are just health recharges. I wouldn't use all of those.
Oh.
I just noticed what they were, so.
Yeah, it took me a while, too. Oh, well. Those aren't lives, those are health recharges.
Yeah, because I think you have infinite lives. You just have all. You have infinite lives and infinite continue. It's just every time you die, you.
Oh, shit!
I was trying to tell you.
I'm just gonna redo this part. Oh, and it's yellow, which I wouldn't have known.
Yeah. It's purple and yellow. Everything I did was black and yellow. I think we needed some black and yellow. It would be so much easier if Leo was fighting this guy.
Why?
Well, where is it? No, it's not Leo, it's Pohatu is the one who has one of his special talents is animal talking. Each one of them have like two abilities. They have one which is their mask ability and one which is just their general ability. Like Tahu here has fire resistance, which he didn't really demonstrate that well.
But he also has his shield.
Yeah. which technically should be limited to him, but I'm pretty sure most of the other ones can do it as well.
Then there's 5 Matoi in this mission, we have 4 of them.
Why can't I just hit them with my flaming sword? Why do I have to launch like balls of fire at them? I don't know. I find that kind of redundant. As much as we were saying we love this game, we're critiquing it really harshly. Speaking of critiquing it really harshly, what were you surprised at the other day, EC?
Oh yeah, I was looking at the game ratings, and like, this game actually got pretty crap ratings, but I don't care what the game critics say, because I love this game, because it's like my childhood in a nutshell. Oh, there's the last Matoran. Yeah, I don't think this
Why
is
this a boss? Oh, yeah, there.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, I'll think there's 25 minutes.
Well, no, you still have to go back and go through the other door, remember?
Oh, yeah. Plays an E-rated child's game. It says motherfucker more than anything else. Okay. So that's how you kill them quickly.
I'm the best.
Hoorah!
Or we could just teleport there. That's cool too.
And now they're gonna go, hoo, wah, ha, ho, ho.
Like shark bait, ooh, ha, ha. Why are there only 2 Matoran actually doing anything, even though you had the rest of your 5? I think he's happy face.
No, it doesn't get my health. Oh well. One of these guys should be able to regenerate. Oh, there's some health. And here's Zaraki.
Yeah, some of them are friendly, like that one looks kind of like a weasel.
There's more of a leopard, right?
Oh, the puma. Shut up. Oh god, this was not a fun part. Oh. Okay, maybe I was thinking of a fun part. Nope, this is the part I was thinking of.
So we missed 3 somewhere. So these are the Bora. They were summoned by the Matuta to be assholes. Hakuna Matata.
Now which ones are these? Are
Yeah, because we can't see color except for on our computer.
Actually,
can I?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I went to look over and see if
they're white.
It looks like they're different colored. I think it's the lock on that's bugging us. We should probably go back and find those other 3 like things.
Well, they got crushed by that giant pillar that's
down. Oh, yeah. I like how that sounds like a lot of weapons. What? Holy crap. This is funny. It's been this long since I played this game. I killed one of them. This is how you do this boss fight. Now that we're doing it right. Boss fight, you're doing it right. Oh, and rhyming, you're doing that right too. So the Boroks are technically empty shells controlled by their Krana, which are these little like organic life forms that are inside their head. You take the Krana out and...
they basically come back.
Yeah.
That one just totally fell in the lava, but okay.
Now the Krana are kind of like a hive mind, so they all like share one thought process.
They're controlled by their...
I kill the boss. Okay. And let's just jump for joy in front of a Krana. I don't pick it up. It's a purple Krana.
What's it doing to mine? Where I must tell the others. Krana, sightseeing, are you?
To a town. I was investigating the totems and saw a great Kanoe mask floating on the lava.
You should return to the Tora. It's dangerous here.
I got a 97 out of 100. So now you know where 97 light stones are. Don't know where 3 are. I'll save it as quest 1. Okay. So, with the completion of this save...
holy shit, that was 22 minutes.
So, we'll call this an episode, because that's a damn long episode. This is Echoing Clock.
And Ripper 95.
And we'll see you next time.
Peace. Oh, shit!
Okay, stop recording the audio.